This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. It's so good today. Today is Father's Day. It's so good that God has brought us this day and brought us here so that we can all be together and praise Him today. All right, my first scripture will be Habakkuk 3:17-18. It says, though the fig tree does not bud and there are no grapes on the vines, though the olive crop fails and the fields produce no food, though there are no sheep in the pen and no cattle in the stalls, yet I will rejoice in the Lord. I will be joyful in God my Savior. So as a believer, although we don't see it right now, that doesn't mean that we don't have it. We don't walk by what we see. We walk by what we believe. So you may not see it right now, but you say, Lord, I trust you and I believe in your word. Because if you said it, I believe it. My next scripture will be Lamentations 3:22-23. Which reads, because of the Lord's great love, we are not consumed, for his compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. So this is telling us that whatever circumstance that we're going through, we're not consumed. We're not consumed by our present state because we know that his love never fails for us. And great is his faithfulness. If he promised it, he will deliver. And his word will not return to him void. So we stand on the word. It doesn't matter what it looks like. We say, Lord, we trust you. No matter what it may seem like, we know what the word says. And we know that God is for us. If God is for us, who can be against us? He always comes through. Father God, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you, Father God, for bringing us all here safely today, God. I thank you, Father God, that we praise you, we worship you, Lord, that we forget what may be on the outside, Lord, but we, Father God, we worship you, Father God, in spirit and in truth because you seek the true worshiper. I thank you, Father God, that as the word goes forth today, that it falls on good ground, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Father God, that we walk by faith and not by sight. We don't walk by what we see, Lord, but we trust in you. We trust in your word, and we trust in you with all of our hearts and lean not to our own understanding. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father God, for your precious son, Jesus, that died on the cross for his blood. We thank you, Father God, for your great love for us. Because of your great love for us, Lord, we are not consumed in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Father God, that we lift our praises to you. We worship you in spirit and in truth, Lord. In your precious son, Jesus' name, let me pray. Amen.
out of our hearts how good the Lord is. And when we praise Him and worship Him, it reminds us of how good He is. It reminds us of His promises to us. Instead of focusing on what's wrong, or instead of focusing on the trouble, it reminds us how good God is and what we're entitled to. So we can lift our hands in this place on today.
What you want to do with us today, Jesus? Have your way. We want you to heal in this place. We want you to deliver on today. Set us free, Jesus. From the inside.
Thank you.
Don't just kneel there. Worship. everybody to pray. Mouth speak death and not life. when we live this life that's been born again, when we live it like sinners, we live it like unbelievers, forgive us, Lord. When we take your name in vain, forgive us. When we live like the world and act like the world, talk like the world, think like the world, go places like the world, God, forgive us. And help us, Lord. Help us, Lord, that we will reverence you at all times. That we will reverence the God in us at all times. At all times, we will bless your name. At all times, we will lift you up. God, we know that only what we do for Christ will last. Strengthen us, Lord, when we're weak. Give us wisdom, Lord, that we may be led by your Spirit, that we will walk in newness of life. Cleanse us, God, from all unrighteousness. For we are the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for coming. Hallelujah. Jesus is the way. He says, I am the way. You might not know the way, but he says, I am the way. Truth. Peace of the Lord that you can't purchase. Maybe you walked in and you weren't at peace, but you can enter into peace. You have to enter into it. And then you have to just dwell in peace. Peace is a hiding place for the believer. It's a resting place for the believer. Amen. It's a place where you don't have to try to figure it out, but God already has it figured out. A place where you don't have to labor, but God has already labored for us. It's just a place of rest. You just took a deep breath and just got home from work and just was so happy to just sit down and take your shoes off. Well, that's what God wants you to do. The evening of the sixth day, he created man. In the beginning of the seventh day, he said, rest. He said, I've already provided everything for you. Everything that Adam would have ever needed, God had provided it for him. And now all Adam had to do was rest and be led by the Lord, be led by the Spirit of God to take what God had already provided and use it as resources and provision. And so all that you need, God has already provided. Resting means I don't have to work. Bible said, let not your heart be troubled. If your heart is troubled, now you're worrying. But the Bible said, let not. Nobody can let not for you. You got to let not for yourself. You're the only one that can let not. And the way you let not is by trusting and standing on the Word of God. the promises of God. If he said it, it will come to pass. Amen. So I can rest on what he has said and know that what he has said is going to come to pass. But it's going to happen only by faith. I have to have faith. My faith moves God. You want to move God? You want to move the hand of God? Move the hand of God by faith. Only by faith. Amen. And the song says, all I want is to what? To glorify you, to lift you up, to praise you. And you got to say that on your own sometime. All I want is to lift him up, to glorify him, to praise him. That he'll be lifted high. Hallelujah. Touch your neighbor. Reach out and touch your neighbor. Hallelujah. Say to your neighbor, say, I've got the power and the authority given to me through Christ Jesus to bless you. Look at him and say, I bless you. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Presence of God in this place. I just feel the presence of the Lord. The presence of the Lord in here to heal, to deliver, to set free, to make whole, to make brand new. I feel the presence of God here to turn around every situation, every hard thing, every tough thing. I feel the presence of God. I tell you, you can feel the presence of God. Because it's real. Hallelujah. You feel the presence of God. You just allow yourself to believe that his presence is in this room. You can feel it in your body. You can feel God healing your body. You can feel God healing your mind. You can feel God taking the pressure and the struggle away. Amen. And it says, if you keep your mind on him, he will give you. That's not any kind of peace. It's perfect peace. Amen. If your mind is on him, it's perfect. Perfect peace. Anybody need some of that perfect peace? I tell you, ain't nothing wrong with storing it up. Even if you don't need it right now. Just store some of that peace up. Because one day you're gonna need it. When you need it, it'll already be there. Amen. Hallelujah. That peace that calms every storm. That peace that when you hear bad news from your doctor, bad news about your children, that peace you've already got stored up. You ain't heard nothing yet, but you got it stored up. That you know that God is a right now God, that he's an able God, that he's a willing God. You put that in your pocket. Amen. My grandfather used to keep money in his wallet. And we didn't see him all the time. Mostly saw him at family reunions. But he would have a little compartment in his wallet. Within the main section, it was a little compartment. That money was in there so long that when he opened it up, it started to crumble. And because he didn't see us all the time, he stored it there. So that when he saw us, he'd be able to pull that money out. He'd be able to bless us. Amen. It's good to store stuff up. But when you see that trouble coming, that problem coming, you don't expect it. Nobody expects trouble. We know it's coming because Jesus said that in this world there's tribulations and trials. He said, but be of good cheer. He said, I've overcome. So we're old enough and wise enough to know that trouble always comes. Doesn't it come? But you got to be ready for it. You got to be ready for it. So you got to keep your mind stayed on him. That he'll give you perfect peace. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So you don't fall apart when things happen. You don't break down when things happen. You don't lose your mind when things happen. Don't think about suicide when things happen. You just stand. Anybody ever just stood in the storm? And the problem is you ain't even in the eye of the storm yet. So you know the worst has not yet come. But you're able to stand. Stand on what he's already brought you through. Remembering what he's already done for you. Knowing that he's faithful. Hallelujah. No longer wringing your hands out. You can eat. You no longer lost your appetite. Just that name brings so much peace, so much assurance that I'm gonna be all right. I'm gonna get through this. They don't know what, how you got the money. Say, if I would have lost my child, if I would have lost my husband, if I would have lost my wife, if I would have lost my job, I would have lost my mind. That's what some people say, but they look at you and they say, I don't know how. I don't know how she made it through that. But you know, if it had not been for God. Well, I always go back, and I thank my mom for taking us to church. I used to say, you know, people say, you know, don't just take them to church, bring them to church. I don't care how she got me there, if she would have dropped me off at the front door, I'm glad she took me to a place. Went with her, but it'd have been good. It'd been good enough for me had she just dropped me off there. Cause just meeting Jesus, did it change your life? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Our God is big. Our God is great. Our God is awesome. God is, he's awesome in power. Hallelujah. Glory. Come on, give the Lord a hand of praise.